We can't predict traffic on the road. Similarly, we can't predict traffic on the computer networks. When the number of packets sent to the network is greater than the capacity of the network, create blockage in the network called the congestion. Normally, congestion is occurred because router have a finite buffer capacity to store the packets. When more packets arrive in the networks and the router reaches its buffer capacity, it simply starts to drop packets. When sender TCP not getting acknowledgements, it's retransmit the segments and it leads more congestion. So in this video, we will learn how TCP controls congestion. So watch the video till the end. When sender TCP sends the segment, it will be acknowledged by the receiver. Here the total time taken known as round trip time, RTT. TCP detects congestion when it fails to receive an acknowledgement for a packet within the estimated timeout. To control the congestion, TCP uses the additive increase, multiplicative decrease, AIMD strategy. Let's understand it with an example. Here, for better visualization, we will also draw the graph of congestion window versus RTT. Now, TCP uses the slow start algorithm and takes the congestion window to one maximum segment size, MSS. This means that the sender can send only one segment. After the first ACK arrives, the size of congestion window is increased by 1, which means that congestion window is now 2. Now, 2 more segments can be sent. When 2 more ACKs arrive, the size of window is increased by 1 MSS for each ACK, which means the congestion window is now 4. Now 4 more segments can be sent. When 4 ACKs arrive, the size of window increases by 4, which means congestion window is now 8. So you can see in the graph how the congestion window increases exponentially. Slow start cannot continue indefinitely. There must be threshold to stop this phase. The sender keeps track of the slow start threshold. When the size of window in bytes reaches this threshold, slow start stops. TCP goes into the next phase called congestion avoidance. If we start with the slow start algorithm, the size of the congestion window increases exponentially. To avoid congestion before it happens, one must slow down this exponential growth. TCP defines another algorithm called congestion avoidance, which increases the congestion window additively instead of exponentially. Therefore, when the size of congestion window reaches the slow start threshold, in this case it is 8, the slow start phase stops and the additive phase begins. In this algorithm, each time the whole window of segment is acknowledged, the size of the congestion window is increased by 1. So now it is 9. Now the sender TCP sends 9 segments, and once these all acknowledged, congestion window will add by 1. That's 10. Similarly, after round trip time, it will be 11. Then 12. I mean, In the congestion avoidance algorithm, the size of congestion window increases additively until congestion is detected, that you can see in the graph. Now suppose at window size 12, sender sends the segment and it will not get acknowledgements until RTO timer times out. Now the sender can guess that the congestion has occurred. Now in this congestion detection phase, the size of the threshold is dropped to half, that is 6 here, which is known as multiplicative decrease. It also reduces the congestion window back to 1 segment. Now it starts the slow start phase again. In this way, TCP controls congestion by adjusting transmission rate. I am sure you are now clear about how TCP controls the congestion. Thanks and see you in the next video. Bye-bye. If you like this video, press like and subscribe the channel and share the video. And don't forget to press the bell icon for my new video notifications. Thanks for watching.